Good afternoon to all of you. And I would like to thank Director Sir, Dr. S.K. Tiwari, and Course Coordinator, Prabhakar Upadhyay Sir, for giving this opportunity to me. So I am Dr. Ajay Kumar, Assistant Professor at Department of Zoology, Banaras Hindu University. So the topic of today's presentation is vaccine and history behind its discovery. So basically, I thought that most of us heard about this word, means vaccine, and all of us probably vaccinated during our childhood. That's why I selected this topic. So firstly, I will give brief introduction about the vaccine, and then I will go through the history. So vaccine, this is the word which is basically derived from a Latin word, vacca, which means cow. So the term was first time given by Louis Pasteur to acknowledge the work of Edward Jenner for the discovery of smallpox vaccine. So vaccine is mainly categorized into two different types. One is inactivated or killed vaccine, that is basically produced by treating the virulent pathogens either by heat, chemical, or rays like gamma rays. And the example is salt polio vaccine, that is also popularly known as inactivated polio vaccine. So that was first time discovered by Jonas Salk, and on his name, basically the name of this polio vaccine is Salk vaccine. Another one is and this is a kind of chemically modified polio vaccine. Okay, so next one is live attenuated vaccine. This vaccine is produced by attenuating the virulent pathogen in such a way that they are not able to cause the disease into the host. Okay, so the process of generation of attenuated pathogen is basically by growing them in the unfavorable condition or the media having the abnormal condition. Like one is most popular one is BCG, Bacillus Calmette Guerin. That is a vaccine for the tuberculosis. And it was generated by growing one of the bacteria known as Mycobacteria bovis that causes disease in cattle. Okay. By growing that bacteria, Mycobacteria bovis, in the culture media having the increasing concentration of bile for about approximately 13 years. And then that vaccine was generated. And next one is swine polio vaccine, OPV. That is commonly, earlier it was using in the India, that was the OPV, oral polio vaccine. And this is also on the name of one of the scientists who discovered this vaccine, Albert Sabin. Okay. So there are several risks which is associated with either inactivated or killed vaccine or live attenuated vaccine. Because here we are using the whole organism. Sometimes what happens in case of live attenuated vaccine, that pathogen gets reverted back in its normal form. And that may lead to, even we are vaccinating that person or child, that will get affected and that the pathogen will lead to the disease due to injection of or administration of that vaccine, live attenuated vaccine. That is also one of the demerit. And there are also a demerit of inactivated or killed vaccine, okay? Because we are using the whole organism. And that's why another types of inactivated exotoxins and then capsular polysaccharide, all these vaccines came into the light. One is inactivated vaccine, exotoxin, that is also called as toxoid. So basically not the whole pathogen, okay, not the whole pathogen is responsible for causing the disease. In case of corynebacterium, diphtheria and clostridium tetani, these are the bacteria which produces some toxins, and that toxin is basically responsible for causing the disease. So in this case, what scientists did, they modified that toxin and they administered that toxin into the host or the target individual. So example is DPT, diphtheria pertussis and tetanus vaccine. And another one is capsular polysaccharide. Some of the bacteria they form the capsule of the polysaccharide. And that capsular polysaccharide is responsible that's why there is no need to administer the whole organism, whole microorganism or whole pathogen. So it's better to provide only the capsule that is responsible so that the bacteria will not grow, but it will induce the immunity. So example is vaccine for Streptococcus pneumonia. Okay. There are several other forms like recombinant vaccine and then DNA vaccine. I will not go into the detail. So this is the table that is showing the immunization schedule. We all must have to know about the schedule. And here you can see the vaccines, different types of vaccines, and these are the DGH, which are going to be prevented by the help of these vaccines. So now I will bring all of you into the history of the vaccine discovery. So he was the first person, Edward Jenner, who discovered the vaccine. And that is the reason he is known as father of immunology. Okay, he was an English physician. So during his practice, he came to know from a young girl, and the name of girl was Sarah Nelms, that he had already cowpox infection. That was a kind of mild infection. She had already the cowpox infection, so she will not get a smallpox infection. And the sentence of that small girl ignite a desire in his mind that what is the reason behind that? Why is he telling that like that? So what he did, he approached one farmer and convinced him to introduce the liquid portion, which was isolated basically from the pus of the cowpox infected patient. And that farmer convinced, and then Edward Jenner intentionally administered by cutting the arm of that 8-year-old boy. The name of that boy was James Phipps, and injected that liquid portion into that boy. That boy gets sick and soon recovered. After that, means few days later, he intentionally again injected the smallpox virus into the body of that boy, and surprisingly, he observed that he did not get affected, and there was no any symptom of the smallpox. And that was the discovery of smallpox vaccine. So here, this picture is of the one of the patient affected with the smallpox. And here, in this picture, Edward Jenner is injecting the liquid portion which was basically isolated from the cowpox infected person. So we can say that according to Francis Galton, in science, credit goes to the man who convinces the world, not the man to whom the idea first occurs. So next person who contributed a lot in the field of vaccination, the person was Louis Pasteur. He was a French chemist as well as microbiologist. So that time, what was happening? The chicken were dying due to the one of the infection, that was the fowl cholera bacteria infection. So he was basically trying to isolate those bacteria, and he was able to isolate that bacteria, as well as he successfully able to culture that bacteria into the laboratory. So he set up one of the experiment and he called his assistant. And we all know that most of the discovery happened accidentally, and the same thing, the discovery of chicken cholera vaccine, that also happened accidentally. So what happened? Louis Pasteur called his assistant and instructed him for the injection of freshly prepared fowl cholera bacteria into the chickens. But somehow he forget, And from the second day, there was the summer vacation. So he went for the summer vacation. After coming back, his assistant injected that old bacterial culture into the chicken. And as you can see from here, all chicken were survived. So no one died. So again, he was surprised after getting this result. Then again, he set up one of the experiment. What he did, he again cultured the bacteria and he injected the freshly cultured bacteria into the chicken. But due to the limitation of chicken, what happens, he used the old one, which was already exposed by the old bacterial culture. And surprisingly, he found that the healthy chicken, they all died, but this, the chicken which was already exposed with the old culture, that survived. And that's why he concluded that maybe due to the aging, the bacteria get weakened, and he called that weakened bacteria as vaccine. So not only he discovered the vaccine for the chicken cholera vaccine, but he also discovered anthrax vaccine and then rabies vaccine. And there was also a small story behind this, the discovery of rabies vaccine. So he was, that time he was using the rabies vaccine only for the animals, for protecting the dogs from getting infected with the rabies virus. But one day what happened? One young boy, he was approximately of 9 years old, he approached the Louis Pasteur and he was bitten by the dog. And he asked to Louis Pasteur for the treatment. He was totally confused that time what to do. But people who were there in the surrounding, he convinced the Louis Pasteur for the injection of the rabies vaccine. So first time he used rabies vaccine on the human. And that was the first human trial by the Louis Pasteur directly on the human. He injected that vaccine for 12 times within 10 days and that boy survived. So that was the whole story about. But till now, nowhere able to explore the reason behind this humanity. So first time in 1890, Emil von Behring, he was a German scientist, and then only 2 minutes, sir. I will take hardly 2 minutes.
No, you have to manage the
Okay. So next scientist was Eli Metkinko. So even before the discovery of serum component, he already told that there is the cells which are involved in the immunity. And for that, he got the Nobel Prize in 1908. And he is known as father of innate immunity. So the whole presentation gives 3 messages. One is we should must listen to others. And if some things make any sense, then we should must analyze the same scientifically. And it may lead to the fruitful outcomes as Edward Jenner did. Second one is we should not discard the data which does not suit with our expected results. But for the real discovery, we must have to consider and critically analyze the unexpected data like Louis Pasteur. And last one is, if we will do our work honestly and seriously, one day people will definitely going to recognize our work like Eli Metkinko. So thank you for your kind patience and listening to my seminar. Thank you.